So in last class, we are discussing about the displacement work, right? So I think we completed this displacement work. Quickly, I will recall this. Right? Let us consider a cylinder. Inside the cylinder, we have a gas at pressure P, and this is the piston, right? And this gas is exerting pressure over the piston, right? Let us assume the piston is pushed outward direction through a small distance dx. The dx is very, very small. I can even assume it as a zero. Very, very small displacement. Okay. So due to the very small displacement, I am assuming that the pressure is constant throughout the process. The pressure inside the cylinder is constant throughout the process because the displacement of the piston is very, very small. Okay. Right. So we know that as according to work done, as I discussed work done is nothing but the force into displacement, as I discussed in last slide. Work done equal to force into displacement. Therefore, here how to get the force? Force can be calculated by multiplying pressure into area, right? So pressure and area, and that is the force is equal to pressure into area and the distance traveled by the piston. Okay. So we know that area into distance mode is nothing but the volume. So that is small displacement. Therefore, the volume is also very small. It is the dV is the symbol denoting. This is the small volume. Okay. So therefore, the work required to move the piston through a displacement dx is equal to dou w. I'll explain why I am writing dou here. So dou w is equals to p into dV. Suppose if I want to move the piston through the whole length, what I need to do? I need to calculate the total work required to move the piston from inner dead center to the outer dead center. I need to move the piston. Somebody phone is ringing, I think. Okay. Right. Please mute your phones. Okay. Right. So the total work required to move the piston from inner dead center to the complete outer dead center can be calculated by integrating the small work. Integral dou w. Integral dou w is nothing but integral PdV. Okay. Now, so here the total work equal to W, that is equal to integral PdV. Okay. I want to discuss what is difference between dou and D. Okay. Now, suppose if dT is there, right. If dt is there, I can write t2 minus t1. If dw is there, I can write w2 minus w1. But dou w, I can't write w2 minus w1 because this is exact differential and this is inexact differential. That's what. Inexact differential, right? So in order to understand clearly what is the difference between D and Do, you should know what is path function, what is point function. What is path function, what is point function, okay? So time being, you remember Do W is not equal to W2 minus W1, but it is equal to W122. Work required to move the piston from state 1 to state 2, okay? But it is not equal to W2 minus W1. Okay, next slide, I'm going to discuss more about what is path function, what is point function. Okay, so whenever D is there, that is exact differential, therefore I can write T2 minus T1. Whenever dou is there, it is not equal to difference of the two states. It is just work required to from 1 to 2. Okay, so that thing you remember. Next slide, it will be more clear for you. Okay, so far we discussed displacement work. So displacement work W equal to integral PdV. Remember throughout this unit, displacement work equal to W equal to integral PdV, where P is the pressure and dV is the small volume. Okay, right. Now, so if you see here, initially the piston is at this point. This is the initial position. So we are calling it as 1, state 1. And this is 2, this is the state 2, final position of the piston, right? Where P is the pressure of the gas exerting, right? when the piston is moving from state 1 to state 2, as I discussed in the first unit, it has to follow certain process. Yes or no, right? Getting or not? So the process is responsible to change of the state. The process is responsible for the change of the state. Okay. Now this is state 1, this is state 2, right? Let us assume this is the path followed by the system during change of its state, and I am calling it as quasi-static process. The main advantage is quasi-static process is each state, each intermediate states are in equilibrium, means the reversal is possible. That is the main advantage of quasi-static process, right? Let us assume this is the path followed by the system during change of 1 to 2, okay? Let us say this is now. I am assuming only small displacement dx, okay? So this is from here to here. Let us say this is the displacement dx, right? Now, I want projected area, right? How to get the projected area? So from the top, if you see, let us say if you extend from here to till x-axis, nothing but your volume. Now this is your projected area. The hatched portion is the projected area. Always remember the area under PV diagram, the area under PV diagram gives the work done. Always the projected area of PV diagram gives the work done. That may be work required or work delivered, whatever it may be, right? So the area under PV diagram gives the work done. Here in this case, the work done by the system, because we are pushing the piston outward direction, this is the work done by the system, right? So this is the work done required here. Okay, now so this total will become volume dv. Okay, now here the expansion of gas in outward movement can be represented our PV diagram. Yes, okay, that is clear. The shaded area represents the work done due to the small movement of the piston, that is integral pdv. So this is the meaning of that, right? The shaded area under PV diagram gives always work done. This is equal to area of the shaded portion. Area of the shaded portion, right? Area of the shaded, right? Let us assume dx is very, very small. Dx is very, very small. Okay. So then this can be assumed as a straight line. Though this is a curve, for small displacement, I can assume it as a straight line. Okay. Now, so by seeing the PV diagram, we can say that the specifying the end points, let us say 1, 2, is not sufficient to get the work done, because so does not determine the work, because let us say the path may follow from here to here and it can reach 2, or it may follow 1, 2, 2 like this and it can reach. The end states are same, but the path followed, the process is different. Now can you say, is the area will be same? Let us say if I consider dx on this curve, this is the area, projected area, and if I consider small displacement over this process and this is the projected area, what happens to the projected area? Projected area is keep on changing, right? Na means the work done depends on the path followed by the system, not only end states. Apart from the end states, it also depends upon the path followed by the system during the change of the state. That is the main meaning of this diagram. You can see if the system follows 1C2, this is the work done required. This is very, very small. And if the system follows 1, 2, 2 via B, if the system follows 1, 2, 2 via B, this is the area under the dx. And if it follows 1A2, this is the area under dx, right? So if you observe, the area is keep on changing, means the work done is also keep on changing. That is the main intention of this, right? Means by seeing PV diagram, we can say that specifying the end points 1 and 2 does not determine the work or area. The nature of the curve needs to be known in order to calculate the work done. The nature of the curve is nothing but the process followed is required. Okay, therefore work is a path function, because the work depends upon the path followed during the change of the state, and it's not a point function. This is one reason, and I'll explain one more reason also, right? Is it clear why we are calling work as a path function? Anyone please reply.
Yes sir.
If you have any doubt, you can ask me.
No doubt sir.
Right, because the work depends upon the process, nothing but the path followed by the system. That is the reason why we are calling work as a path function, not a point function. Okay, one more reason also I'll tell you in the next slide. Right.
So what is example of point function?
Yeah, next slide it will be clear. Next slide it will be clear. Okay. Just now, time being note down. Remember what is path function is clear, right? Path function is the it is the work and heat also a path function because these always depends on the process. Okay. Right. I'll explain in detail. So we got just now displacement work W equal to integral PdV from state 1 to 2. Right. So in order to calculate the work, then you should know the relation between P and V, or else you should know the path. Okay, it is required to find the relation between P and V or the path. If you know the path, indirectly you know the relation between P and V. Okay, so what are the properties of the work? Some of the important functions of the work, right? So we'll see. Work is the energy in transit, and it can be identified only when the process is being executed. When the process is being executed, then only we can identify the work is going to done or work is done on the system. Okay, so work does not exist either before or after the interaction. Only during the interaction we can observe. Once it is over, we can't find work is happening or not, right? Now, second one is the it is the boundary phenomenon. It is nothing but it is interaction across its boundary, right? So it always a boundary phenomenon. And the next property is it is something which happens to a system, but it is not the characteristics of a system. Because what is characteristic? So while discussing point function, path function, it will be clear what is characteristic. This is nothing but property. Okay. So while discussing point and path function, it will be clear. And being an inexact differential, work interaction is represented as dou W instead of dW because it is inexact differential. Therefore, we can write dou W is not equal to W2 minus W1. Rather, we can write W122 or W122. This is the way to represent the work. Okay. So I'll discuss what is right. Now, when it is valid, what are the you can say limitations for this displacement work. So these are the limitations we can say. So this is only for the closed system. This equation is valid if the system is closed, means there is no mass interaction, only heat interaction can take place, and the process should be quasi-static process. You know that quasi-static process is infinitesimally slow process, so that all the intermediate states of the system are in equilibrium state. That is frictionless and reversible. The main advantage of quasi-static process is if the process follows quasi-static process, it is reversible. Means let us say this is state 1, this is state 2. If it follows quasi-static process, 1 to 2 is possible, again 2 to 1 is also possible. That is the meaning of reversible. Okay. And there are no viscous effects within the system, and there are no the effects due to gravity, electricity, electric current and magnetization are negligible, right? So W equal to integral PdV for quasi-static process, nothing but reversible process. For irreversible process, W is not equal to PdV. For irreversible process, W is not equal to PdV. That is for non-quasi-static process. Okay, now I will explain in detail what is path function and what is point function, right? So blindly you can remember, if it is possible to represent over a graph by a point, that is called point function. If you are able to represent any property by a point on a graph, let us for example take, let us assume temperature. Is it is possible to represent temperature by a point on TS diagram? Yes or no? Reply.
Yes, sir.
Right? Yes, we can represent temperature by a point on a TS diagram. Or let us take PV diagram. I can represent pressure by a point, volume by a point. Means these are all point functions. Point function is nothing but it is possible to represent by a point on a graph. Simple definition I am saying, right? For easy understanding. See, if it is possible to represent by a point on a graph, then those are called point functions. Okay? And all point functions are properties. I'll tell you in the next slide what is property. Okay? Right. And if it is not possible to represent by a point, rather we can represent by an area. That is called path function. Let us say, is it possible to represent work done by a point? PV diagram. Is it possible to represent work done by a point?
No.
No. Because let us say when the system is following 1-2-2, always the area under 1-2-2 gives the work done. Yes or no? Right? Always the area under PV diagram gives the work done. Here the work done is represented by area rather than point. Right? If it is not possible to represent by a point, or if it is possible to represent by an area, then we can call those are path functions. The example are heat and work. We can't represent by a point, rather we can represent by an area. So that's why heat and work are the path functions. And all path functions are inexact differential. All path functions are inexact differential. That is the symbol we are denoting with do. And all point functions are exact differential. We can denote with dt, dp. That is the main reason behind that. Okay. If you see here in the figure, state 1, state 2. 1-2-2, the system is following through A, and 1-2-2, it is also following B. Right? So V1 is clear, we can represent by a point. Even P1 also I can represent by a point. And V2 I can represent by a point, and P2 also I can represent by a point. So therefore, pressure and volume are point functions. But if I want to calculate work done, if the system follows 1A2, what is the area? This is the area under the diagram. So this is the work done if the system follows 1-2-2 via A. Suppose if the system follows 1-2-2 via B, then what is the work done? This is the work done, right? So this work done is less compared to 1-8. Means if I want to use minimum work, which it has to follow? The system has to follow which process? 1A2 or 1B2 in order to be minimum work, which process I need to follow?
1A2.
If I follow, the area is more. If I follow 1B2, the hatched area is less, right? If I follow 1B2, the area under the curve is minimum. Observe carefully, 1B2. Yeah. If the system follows 1B2, this is the projected area. But if the system follows 1A2, this area is extra. Getting or not? The system has to do this much portion extra if it follows 1A2. That's why always the work done is path function. The work depends upon the path followed by the system. Whereas pressure and volume does not depend on the path, they depend only point. And all point functions are exact differential. And all path functions are inexact differential, right? So now we can see here, their magnitudes depends on the path followed, path function, first one. Their magnitudes depends upon the path followed during a process as well as the end states. So work and heat are the path functions, right? So WA you can see 10 kilojoule and WB is 7 kilojoule, right? Because the area is less for the 1B2 as compared to 1A2. And point function, the point function depends only state, they do not depends on the path followed, right? So now at all properties of process A, V2 minus V1 is possible, and process B, V2 minus V1 is also possible, right? So now during 1A2, 1B2, is there any change in DV value? Answer me. Let us assume V2 is equals to 6 m³. V1 is equals to 3 m³. If the system follows 1A2, what is DV? DV is equals to V2 minus V1. That is 6 minus 3, nothing but 3. And if this is one system, when system follows 1A2, when system follows the path 1B2, what is DV? DV is nothing but V2 minus V1. Here also it is 6 minus 3. Is it depends on the path followed, the volume?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Volume is not, it is independent of the path followed. It depends only on the end states. That is the reason point function is the exact differential, right? So, means they can represent only point. Clear difference between path function and point function? Clear, na? Please answer. If anyone is having doubt regarding point function and path function, very, very, very important concept.
So, yes,
by mistake, if I use DW also, you should warn me. Sir, DW is wrong. It is DOW. even dq is wrong, it is dou q, because heat is a path function, it is inexact differential, we should use dou. Suppose if I use dw also, you should say work is a path function, therefore it is inexact differential, therefore you should use dou symbol. Clear na? By mistake if I use d also, you should correct that. Clear?
Yes sir, clear.
Right, now we will see simple problem. Right, so a gas undergoes a reversible non-flow process. Okay sir, a gas undergoes a reversible non-flow process. So non-flow process means which type of system it is? Closed system. Yes or no? Right? Closed system. Because so while discussing W equal to integral PdV, the limitation is it is applicable for only closed system. Whenever the system is closed system, then only we can use this displacement work. Okay, according to the relation given, P is equals to minus of, sorry, P equal to minus 3V plus 15. Is it is visible the screen what I am writing?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Right. P equal to minus 3V plus 15. That is the relation between P and V. Because as you discussed, in order to calculate the work done, you should know either the path followed or the relation between P and V. But here in the problem, relation between P and V is given. Okay, it's okay, no problem. And where V is the volume in meter cube and P is the pressure in bar. Determine the work done. He is asking calculate the work done when volume changes from 3 to 6 meter cube. V1 is equals to 3 meter cube and V2 is equals to 6 meter cube. This is the data given. Okay. He is asking calculate work done. I can use displacement work because it is a closed system. W is equals to integral PdV V1 to state 1 to state 2. Because here V is the variable. Clear? Clear or not? State 1 to state 2 means volume is going to change. dV, we are integrating with respect to V. So that is equals to integral V1 is how much? 3, V2 is 6, minus 3V plus 15 into dV. Right? Now I can write integral 3 to 6 minus 3V dV. I am expanding integral 3 to 6. 15 dV, right? So that is equals to minus 3 is constant, I can keep outside of the integration. Integral x dx, what is the formula? Integral x dx is equals to anyone? Hey, it's not dy by dx.
Square
by 2. In the same way, integral v dv is equals to v square by 2 between the limits 3 to 6 plus 15 is constant, I can keep outside. Integral x, integral 1 dx is x. Nothing but v 3 to 6. Okay. So that is equals to, if you apply the boundary condition, minus 3 by 2 into 6 square minus 3 square plus 15 outside 6 minus 3. So that is equals to 36 minus 9, how much?
27.
Minus 3 by 2 into 27 plus this is 6 minus 3, right? 6 minus 3 is 3. 15 3 is 45. If you simplify, you will get the answer. So it is 27, right? What is 3 27? 94, huh? 94, right? 84. 81. Tell me something.
Sir, total 4.5.
Minus or plus?
Less only.
4.5 units.
Joules.
1 second. Pressure is given in bar, right? 1 bar is equals to 1 into 10 power 5 newton per meter square into meter cube is the volume. This is the pressure. 1 bar is equals to 1 into 10 power 5 newton per meter square because P into V. volume is meter cube, right? So you will get 10 power 5 Newton meter, right? So that is equals to 10 power 5 joule. Means you should multiply with 10 power 5, and it is unit is joule. Is it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now we'll go to next problem. Right. Consider a gas enclosed in a piston cylinder arrangement. The gas is initially at 150 kilopascal. Okay. So what is the initial pressure is given? P1 is equals to 150 kilopascal. Right. First, I will convert the units. 150 into 1 kilo is 10 power 3. 1 pascal is newton per meter square. Is it is clear conversion? 150 into 10 power 3 newton per meter square. Okay. And occupies a volume. V1 is given. V1 is equals to 0.03 meter cube. The gas is now heated until the volume of the gas increases to 0.1 meter cube. V2 is equals to 0.1 meter cube. Calculate the work done by the gas if the volume of the gas is inversely proportional to the pressure. Given relation that V is equals to 1 by P. So piston cylinder arrangement is nothing but it is a closed system. Is the question is clear? Given data. Is the question is clear or not? Please tell me.
Clear, sir.
Right.
Yes.
So therefore, from this, what can I write? P into V is equals to constant. I can write nothing but P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. I can write now. From state 1 to state 2. So P pressure is inversely proportional to volume is given. Here given that the volume of the gas is inversely proportional to the pressure. So V is inversely, right. From this I can write P2 V1 V1 equal to P2 V2. Okay. So right. From this I can write V is equals to, or P is equals to some constant by V. Right. So what is the formula for work done? Work done is equals to integral 1 to 2 volume V1 to V2 P into dV. P into dV. Right. So we are integrating with respect to what? Rule number 45 is there. Rule number 45. Integral PdV. The integration is with respect to what? Please answer. 45 is there. I'll check. 45 is not there. Okay. 46. 46.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Integral PdV means the integration is with respect to?
Integration PdV.
Integral PdV. We are integrating with respect to?
dV, sir.
dV, volume, right? Means yes. I don't want pressure term. Now I want to write pressure in terms of volume. That's why I written P equal to C by V from this. Clear? Why I wrote P equal to C by V? Now yes. I'm going to substitute P value in terms of volume. So that is equals to integral V1 is how much? 0.03 to V2 is 0.1 and P is some constant by V into dV. So I can write constant outside integral 0.03 to 0.1. 1 by V dV. What is integral 1 by X dX?
Log V.
Log X base E. Yes, sir, right? Integral 1 by X dX is log X base E. Therefore, here I can write C into log V base E between the limits 0.03 to 0.1, right? So, what is C? C I can write either P1 V1 or P2 V2. Agree? Please tell me, C I can replace with either P1 V1 or P2 V2, and again I know P1 and V1, V2 I know, but P2 I don't know. If I want, I can calculate by using this relation, or I don't want because directly C value I can use P1 V1 and log 0.1 base E minus log 0.03 base E. And this is equal to P1 is how much? 150 into 10 power 3 into V1 is how much? 0.03. Anyone is having calculator, please tell me this value. And if you do, you will get the answer. That's it. If anyone is having calculator, please tell me. Otherwise, it's okay. This is the answer. Is it is clear? Important problem. No one is answering. Every time only number 2, number 1 is giving answers. What about others? Roll number 73 is there. Hmm. 72. Then what is the use, Baba? Please tell me. Yeah, roll number 70. You raised your hand. Yeah, can you speak? I can see you raised your hand. Can you speak? That is the main problem with the online. I don't know who is listening, who is not listening. Okay, can anyone please answer, reply? Is it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So when you use this W equal to integral PDV, the first condition should be, it should be closed system.
Closed system.
For non-flow process, I can use this displacement work. Okay, now next I'll discuss two cases where now W equal to integral PDV, right? So in order to exist work done, there should be change in the volume. That is the meaning of this equation, right? If there is change in the volume, then only work will exist. Yes or no? Because the piston is moving from state 1 to 2. When the piston is moving from 1 to 2, there is certain change in the volume. Whenever there is change in the volume, then only work done will exist, right? As of now, we discussed this is a case, right? Now, there are some cases, listen, there are some cases where DV exists, but work done is 0. And some cases, DV is equals to 0, but work done exists. Got my point? So according to this equation, displacement work, if there is change in the volume, work done will exist. But there are some special cases are there. There will be change in the volume, but final work done is 0. Or there is no change in the volume, but work done exists. We will discuss those two cases. Clear what I am going to explain now? There will be change in the volume, but work done is 0. And there is no change in the volume, but work done exists. How it will be, I will see. Now, first case, there will be change in the volume, but work done is 0. How it will be, we will see. Let us consider a system and it is separated by a wall, an imaginary wall. This is the wall, right? One side of the system, I have a gas. Other side of the system, I have a vacuum. Vacuum means nothing, right? Now, suppose if I open this wall, what will happen? If I remove this wall, what will happen to the gas? If the wall is removed, what will happen to the gas?
Gas will flow.
Means
to
the
vacuum.
Gas will occupy the entire volume? Yes or
yes,
no?
Vacuum.
The volume will increase, pressure will decrease, right? Volume will increase, pressure will decrease, meaning that there will be change in the volume will exist. DV exist or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, right now? Right. But here, though there will be change in the volume, but work done will be 0. How it will be, I'll tell you. Because when, so W equal to integral PDV, where P is the pressure, right now, right? So P in the expression stands for pressure against which the gas is expanding. That is the main meaning of integral PDV. Integral PDV is nothing but there is a pressure P against which the piston is moving. Okay, against which the gas has to move. But is there any restriction? Let us say this is the P. Is there any restriction for the gas on the other side?
No, sir.
Restriction because of vacuum, right? When there is no restriction, so the here the pressure against which the gas is expanding, in the case of free expansion, the external pressure is zero. Here the pressure is zero, hence the work done is zero. When there is no external opposing force, therefore the work done is zero. This is one way of explaining why the work is zero. The second way is, so work is the transfer of the energy between the system and surrounding, as we know, and when there are unbalanced or imbalanced forces between them, right? Here is, in this case, is there any unbalanced force between these two systems? Is there any unbalanced force between these two systems? No, because here there are no forces at all, because vacuum here, right? So when there are no unbalanced forces, there is no work done. Yes or no, right? So this is the other way of explaining why work is zero. Why work is zero, right? No. So here, because there is no external force or there is no resistance, that is the one case, and there are no unbalanced force here, because when there is pressure, then only unbalanced force. If you remember mechanical equilibrium, what is meant by mechanical equilibrium? If there are no unbalanced force, means there is no change in the pressure. If delta P or dP is zero, then we can say that it is in mechanical equilibrium. When there are unbalanced forces exist within the system, then only work done will be there, right? Okay, right. Clear now this one?
Yes.
Right now, because here dV exists, but work is zero because there is no restriction for the gas. And the second case I will explain, where work done is exist, but dV is equals to zero. Now you see here, let us assume piston cylinder arrangement. Here we have water under room temperature. Let us assume initially water is at room temperature, and rope is wrapped around, and let us say initially the weight is here. Okay, now the rope is wrapped around this pulley. Let us say this is the pulley. Okay, now at this point, let us say when the weight is at the top position, which type of energy it has? Because it has a weight, what is the energy possessed by this body?
Potential
energy, because it is certain height from the reference. Let us say this is my reference, this is my datum or reference, right? So initially the weight is at this point because it is wrapped around the pulley. Now if I release this weight, what will happen? It will move downward direction. Let us say this is the h, and let us say when the weight reaches the ground, what happens to this pulley? Pulley starts rotating. Agree? Yes or no? When the weight is moving downward direction, the pulley starts rotating. When the pulley starts rotating, this side I have some stirrer mechanism. Let us say stirrer mechanism. What will happen? It will rotate inside this liquid, right? So when the shaft rotating, when the stirrer rotating, right, what will happen? It is creating certain disturbance to the fluid exist within this system, and means it will create certain friction to the particles nearer to the system. Thereby the temperature of the water rises. Means if you observe, let us say when the, after moving this full weight downward direction, means after rotating this pulley, the temperature of the water increases. There will be change in the temperature of the system. Is there any change in the volume of the system? No change in the volume. dV is equals to zero, but dT exists. Temperature difference exists because of the stirring arrangement. Because if you stir that, what will happen due to the friction? The temperature of the particles are increased. That is the reason work will exist, right? So here, when the mass moves downward direction, the paddle, we can say, yes, paddle wheel rotates, the differential work transfer is equal to the decrease in the potential energy of the mass, right? So when the mass is at this point of time, what is the potential energy? Mgh. When the mass reaches the ground, potential energy is zero. What is the change in the potential energy? Mgh. Okay, So that is the decrease in the potential energy and is given by delta W equal to T into d theta, where T is the torque transmitted by the shaft and d theta is the angle turned by the shaft. T into d theta, so there is the work done in terms of torque and angle of twist. We can say theta is the angle of twist, nothing but the angle turned. Angle of twist is nothing but the angle turned, and T is the torque of the shaft. Okay, right. So therefore, total work transfer equal to integral T into d theta, right? Where T is equals to m into g into dz, right? This is the change in the potential energy. M into g into h. I am saying here is assuming dz. Z is the datum here, right? So due to the increase in the temperature, work done is exist. The paddle wheel work arises from the resistance offered by the fluid, because when the stirrer is rotating, this fluid will offer certain resistance. If there is no fluid, it will rotate at faster. Due to the presence of fluid, right, it offers certain resistance to the stirrer or paddle wheel. Therefore, it creates certain resistance to the movement. Okay, so it creates the resistance offered by the fluid to the paddle rotation. Though the volume is zero, but due to the rotation of paddle, the temperature of the fluid is raised. The temperature of the fluid is raised, which means that work is done on the system by the surrounding, but reversal is not possible. What is the meaning of reversal? Suppose, let us say, initially the temperature is 25 degree at room temperature when the weight is at the top position. Now, after rotating, after moving the weight downward direction, let us say the temperature is raised to 28 degree centigrade. Now, suppose if I cool this water from 28 to 25, will this weight move upward direction?
No.
No. This is the meaning of reversal is not possible. Means it is possible in only one way. It is not possible in the reverse direction. Got it, na? That's right. If the water temperature is increased from 25 to 28, suppose if you cool the temperature from 28 to 25, this weight will not move upward direction. Okay. So these are the two cases where the work done is not equal to the integral PdV. The one is the free expansion process. This is the free expansion or unrestrained. Unrestrained is nothing but unrestricted expansion. There is no nothing restriction here exists. That's why the work done is zero, though the volume change exists. And the second case is the paddle wheel or stirrer work. There is no change in the volume, but due to the increase in the temperature, nothing but the change in the potential energy of the weight will be used to do the work done. With this, we will stop today, and next class we will discuss about heat. Okay, any doubt till here, please ask me. Any doubt till here, please ask me.